Good morning. Welcome to Battle Branch. If you're glad to be here this morning, just say amen.
Amen.
All right. Anybody not glad to be here? We're all glad. It is good to be in God's house this morning. Those of you that are here live, we have some that's traveled a long ways to be with us and some that have traveled not so long. Good to have every one of you. Have a baptizing this evening after the service down at Madison's Creek, so I'm sure you'll give some directions to that. Do we have any birthdays? Well, I know we had one a couple weeks ago that wasn't here. Anna, 10 years old, had a birthday. She asked if she could stand up today. So I just went ahead and called her out. Any more birthdays? Right back here. I'm going to tell you what.
Tell them to stand up.
Okay, everybody's had a birthday. Stand up. Feel like Bob Vicker sometimes. He would always say, "What's your daddy's name?" I don't recognize him. I have to ask who their parents and grandparents are now. Jim, where are you at, Jim? Whitmire. Did you want to? Don't make. He said, "I wasn't feeling too good. I ought to go ahead and call it out today." You're looking good, though. All right, birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
And we have a couple that is having their 61st anniversary, Rocky and Sharon Salter.
All right.
If we could all look that good after 61 years. Any more anniversaries this week? Just pains. Dawson, that was a fast year. Oh, Dennis and Sue. Adam, did you raise your hand? Who, what? Oh, okay. All right, is that it?
Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary. God bless you. Happy anniversary to you.
Okay, I'm not going to guilt you into coming up here today, but those of you that would like to join us in the choir, but I want to include everybody that came up last week, I want you to come up, and then any more, y'all come up too. And bring the Songs of Faith book. And the rest of you that are not coming up, be looking for a book, because we're going to have a congregational song to start off with. And I'm going to ask all of you to stand and sing with us. And it's going to be page 341, Love Lifted Me. Everybody stand, and we're going to sing Love Lifted Me.
Love Lifted Me, but I don't know what page it is.
I'm always nervous. I don't know. I don't feel worthy to even stand in this altar, but I've been asked more than once to sing The Anchor Holds. Of course, you know, if I stand, I don't have but a couple songs, but I have been working on some other songs, but I'm so slow about working on them that I don't ever get them ready. So, but anyway, I'm going to try to sing The Anchor Holds. And Chad asked me to sing this yesterday. When I asked him to do a favor for me, he asked that I do a favor for him. And Dina's asked me, there's been several people asked me to sing, but all I want is for God to be in the song when I stand to sing it, and then that's fine. And I just pray that God would be in it. Y'all help me if you can. Monitors on one. I can't hear it. I have journeyed through the long dark night. Out on the open sea, by faith alone, sight unknown, and yet his eye watching me, the anchor holds. Though the ship is battered, the anchor holds. Though the sails are torn, I have fallen on my knees as I face the raging sea. The anchor holds in spite of the storm. I've had visions. I've had dreams. I've even held them in my hand. But I never knew they would slip right through. Like they were only grains of sand. The anchor holds, though the ship is battered. The anchor holds, though the sail are torn. I have fallen on my knees as I face the raging sea. The anchor holds in spite of the storm.
When God proved His love to me, the anchor holds. Though the ship is battered, the anchor holds. Though the sails are torn, I have fallen on my knees as I face raging sea. Anchor hold in spite of the storm. I have fallen on my knees as I face raging sea. Anchor hold in spite of the
If you know Jesus as your Savior, you know that the anchor will hold. He's held me so many times. Thank you, Brian. This song that I'm going to sing is a song for all of us. But if you don't know Jesus as your Savior, one day we're going to all face a judgment, and we need to know what we're going to say. If we can say anything. So how will you plead? I'm sending this message to all who will listen. This isn't just some fairy tale. Life as we know it soon will be ending. Judgment is coming. God's word will not fail. Blood Jesus shed. God sent His Son, His only begotten. He died on the cross and He settled the debt. judged on that day. How will you plead when Satan cries guilty? Can you declare I'm saved and set free? Will you have Jesus to prove you've been pardoned? When we stand before him, how will you plead? When we stand before him, how will
Amen. Good to be here. Good to see everyone out in the house of the Lord. Just thank God for everyone that's here. And, you know, I sat in the thinking about the Lord and him coming. And, you know, one day he is coming. He's coming to get his church. And we wonder a lot of times, you know, who is the church? It's those that are born again. So I want us all to think about this today. You know, we come and sometimes we just sit down and really don't think about God, but we really need to think about the day that we're going to leave here. God has given us opportunity to come to this world and be here and live a life here in this world. And I wondered a lot, you know, well, why? Why does it be this way or that way? But I believe that the Holy Spirit showed me that the reason that we're here is to make the decision on where we're going to spend eternity. Because the Bible plainly tells us and teaches us that inside of every one of us is a soul, and that's you that is inside that body. And we know that this body is not going to live forever, that it's going to go back to the dust of the earth. But there's a soul inside of us, and that soul will live for eternity. And we think, well, how is God, or why would God send this person to hell and this person to heaven? Well, it's our choice. We make that choice here. And everybody says, well, if it's my choice, I want to go to heaven. Everybody wants to go to heaven. But will we step out like the Bible says by faith and believe what God says? Now, this is the Word of God. God inspired men to write this Bible. This Bible is a roadmap that will lead us to heaven. Now, I know the times that we're living in, and seems like the world is getting more wicked every day. And I believe we'll all have to agree to that. The things that me and Diane was talking yesterday about kids and how that used to kids could go out. I'm talking about small children, could go out and play. And you wasn't worried about nobody bothering them. But now everything is changing. And people are killing people just for a few dollars. And all this is changing. And I'll tell you something. The prophecy and the Word of God is being fulfilled every day. But what happens, and this happened before the flood, people get used to the things that happen. They live in it, they see it, and then they start getting used to the things. Well, Noah preached. And he told people that God had told him to build an ark. Now, I've used this illustration before, but I want you to think about it just for a minute. Noah preached the word, and he told them, he said, God is going to destroy this world. All the people in the world, everything that breathes the breath of life, is going to be destroyed if they don't come inside this ark. Now, they went on, and there was only 8 people that believed that and got in that ark. So the Bible says that as time went on, God told Noah, he said, all right, Noah, it's time to get in. Noah walked in the doors of the ark, and God, the Bible said that God shut the doors. Okay? The door was shut. Now, I want you to think about this. I'm not going to go on for a long time this morning. I had studied a message. I don't feel like that's where I need to go. I feel like I need to talk to you about this just for a minute. And I want you to think about this. I want you to think seriously about this. I truly believe, I've studied this for many years, and what I've understand and what I do understand, the Lord is coming. And it's not going to be as long as it has been. I don't know the day nor the hour, but I know for a fact that the things that's prophesied in this book is coming to pass. And I want you to look at it like this now. The door to that ark was standing wide open. The doors probably were so big that Noah couldn't shut them. And I can't shut the doors to salvation. I cannot do that. I can encourage you to come and get saved. But that is something you have to do. You say, okay, Madison, I'm interested in being saved. How can I be saved? The Bible says that if I realize that I am a sinner, and the Bible teaches that we all were born in sin, and we are sinners, and if I realize that I'm a sinner, and I come to Jesus Christ, I come to God, and I kneel on my knees, realizing that Jesus Christ went to the cross and took my sins and died for my sins. That's too simple, Madison. That's too simple that I could get up out of my seat right now and kneel down and ask Jesus to come into my heart and save my soul and I'd be saved. That's too simple. Well, let me ask you this. The people that God told, God said, I'm going to destroy this earth, everything that breathes a breath of life in this earth. But those that will believe me, come through the door and get in this ark, and you'll be saved. Simple thing as walking through the door to the ark, and they were saved from the flood. That's very easy, wasn't it? Very easy. I'm sure there's people that mocked, made fun of them, but they believed what God said. People, we're living a life right here. This life, some of us, is done going down the other side. Some of us has not reached that yet. But let me tell you something. This life will soon, as we know it, soon be over. I had a friend one time, and he asked me, he said, what if you're wrong? I said, what if you're wrong? People, I want to tell you something. I had doubts until Jesus spoke to my heart. Did you feel the Holy Spirit come in here? Did you feel something different in your life that you have not felt in a while? I know we're not saved by feelings, but the Spirit of God will draw. Did you feel something that was tugging inside your soul? Let me tell you what that was. That was the Holy Spirit of God. And I want to tell you this today. Jesus Christ said, I am the door. And if you enter in, you must enter in through Him. Now, how do I do that, Madison? Let me tell you what. If you will kneel down, and you say, why do I have to kneel? We humble ourselves. Humble ourselves before God. He is Almighty God. And if we will come and kneel before God today and ask God to come into our heart and forgive us of our sins, He will save your soul and your name will be wrote in the Lamb's Book of Life. And when you leave this life, and you will leave the body that you're in. Every one of us is going to. And your soul is going to live for eternity. And we will choose down here whether I accept Jesus, if I'm going to walk through that door, which is Jesus, and the Bible says it's through faith, through faith. And I want to tell you something today. If you'll believe what this book has said, and I have told you what this book says this morning, if you will believe and you'll come and kneel down and ask Jesus into your heart, you can be saved. Young man, we're going to baptize. We're going to baptize several here at right after church. Met me right back here this morning, young boy, and he said, I'm going to be baptized today, ain't I? I said, yes, you are. And I wanted to hear it from him. I said, what happened to you? He said, I got saved. What did he do? He believed in Jesus Christ and asked him to come into his heart and save his soul. People, that's all you got to do is walk through that door this morning. That's all you have to do is just believe that. Walk through that door and Jesus will save your soul. And I want to say this to the rest. If you're saved, and I know that we're living in trying times and troubling times. I know we're there. But if you have a need today, by faith, if you'll step out and come to God, God is able to meet your need, whatever it may be. So I'm going to ask you all to stand right now. And I know that God is here. And I know that He's speaking to hearts. And would you be willing this morning to step out of your comfort zone and walk into the doors that Jesus has opened for you here today? Right now, as He speaks to hearts, would you step out and come and kneel in this altar, and let's pray about whatever is on your heart and whatever your need may be. Will you? Will you right now just come and kneel down here and talk to the Lord? But I want to tell you, God is able to meet whatever needs you might have here today. Will you? What about it? Will you come right now? Come on as God speaks. All I want to do is do what God says, and I'm going to ask everybody to bow your head. Right now, if He's tugging at your heart, would you step out right now and come on and let's pray. We're going to pray with all these in just a minute. Is there something you want to just put in the hands of God and allow God to guide and lead your life? Why don't you do that right now? We're going to pray. God bless every one of you that's coming. Any others? Come on. As all heads are still bowed, I want to say this. If there's one in this altar or in this building that's never been saved, I want you to just lift your hand up and let me come and pray with you, or some of the deacons pray with you. If there's one anywhere, just hold that hand up. I want everybody at will to pray with us, so let's pray at this time. Our Father, we do thank You and praise You, God. Lord, for speaking to our hearts in the ways that You have. And we humbly bow before You and ask Him, Father, that Your will be done in all of our lives. Lord, there's many that's seeking You today and seeking Your will in their lives. And I ask You, precious God, Lord, right now to touch and to do the work in all of our lives that needs to be done. And Lord, if there's any that's lacking the faith that they need, I pray that You'd give that to them. And Father, thank You again for everything and all that You've done and all that You're going to do. So we praise You in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Appreciate you being obedient unto the Lord, and I thank God for being here with us today. As I said, immediately after service, we're going down to the creek below my house, and we're going to baptize some folks there and encourage anybody that can and will come and be with us. And what we're going to do is go on the other side of the creek this time. You've been used to coming into the field there at my house and coming down through there, and I didn't get around to getting that bush hogged, so might be a little rough on some of the ladies having to walk there. So what you need to do this time, and we've done this before, is when you come down to where you did go into my field, just go across the county bridge and come on down the road to that covered bridge, and there's plenty of parking right in there. You can pull in and park out in that little field that's mowed, and so that's where we'll go. So everybody that will, come be with us. And if you've saved and never been baptized, you come and we'll baptize you also. So appreciate everybody being here. Thank you. Pray for our service Wednesday night, and you're free to go.